Hi everyone, welcome back to the Navigant Credit Union Broadcast Center. I'm Go Local News editor Kate Nagel. Happy Halloween. Thanks for joining us for the 4 o'clock News and Politics Hour. I'd like to welcome back a guest who kicked off her campaign with us, Diane Dede Whitman.
Hello.
For mayor of Providence. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
It's certainly been a busy few weeks and a busy 24 hours just coming fresh off of a debate with incumbent mayor Jorge Alorza. Break it down, Monday morning quarterback. How do you think you did?
Well, I think I did okay. It's not often I'm called a liar in a debate. I've been called many things in my life, but I've never been called a liar.
So. And you addressed that at the debate, but if you want to again address those
All
claims,
right.
please do so here.
So I'm being accused of being an insider in the former mayor Buddy CNC's campaign. That's clearly not true. I said it to the mayor last night in the debate that he came to see me, not once, but twice, to ask if I'd work in his campaign. And I only asked one thing of him, and that was, what would he do? How does he feel about the schools? And he said something that gave me the absolute impression that he wanted to dumb down the schools. And I said to him, congratulations, you've dumbed them down. And I say that because the teachers are very upset that there's social promotions. And that is a detrimental effect on everyone. When someone is advanced to a class, they have no right being in. But to get back to the issue at hand, my late husband was sitting there. We were in the patio in my house. And he also went to seek the advice and counsel of Mayor Buddy Cianci himself. He wanted his advice on how to run a campaign and would he help him. And he said, that's not true. And there were witnesses, people at the table with him, and there was someone very reputable sitting at the table.
With the mayor and the former mayor,
yep.
and other witnesses as well.
Yes, and Alan Hassenfeld was sitting at the table next to them and heard the whole conversation. And then I asked him, are all six of us liars? So I think we got him on that.
So talk a little bit about that. As you said, the mayor did approach you. I mean, were you a Buddy insider? I mean, the reason why politicians approach you, if I'm not mistaken, is because you're able to raise money.
Money. I am respected. I am a consultant. I am asked to do a job, and I do that job well, which is why I've been asked by people in both sides of the party. And I've worked from Tony Pires, who is highly respected, to run for governor, up to Clinton's first campaign when he was running for president. So I have a resume I'm proud of. And again, I was so dismayed by Alorza's remarks that I was happy to help anyone who would run against him. And Buddy was that guy.
So let's talk a little bit, both with the debate last night and some materials that are circulating. Are you surprised that the mayor has gone negative? Do you think that's an indication of being aware of the strength of your campaign?
I think, in a way, it's great. If that's what's my dirty little secret. I think that shows he's very nervous. It's really an ugly mailer. And it kind of makes me feel good. This is a campaign. This is a race. You know, when everybody says, why'd you get into it so late? I want them to know that, in fact, my husband died the end of April. I needed time to mourn. And then I got a letter, coincidentally, the night before my ballot was due, the papers were due. And she went through a timeline where she worked with Gary, and the bottom line was she had regrets when she found out he had an accident and then found out he died and never had the opportunity to be with him. And I wanted no regrets in life. I love this city. I want to be mayor of it and bring the energy, the class, the efficiency, and the love back to Providence.
So you've been on the streets since we first had you in when you announced the campaign all around the city. You know, talk with us when you're talking with folks and voters here in Providence, the biggest issues that you're hearing from them.
Well, First, I want to say I am absolutely warmly received in many different wards with many different flavors, many different populations. Everybody is concerned about education and crime and basic services. And that's really what our campaign is about. A town, a city will never thrive unless its kids are educated. And we owe it to everyone. There'll be no economic development if a business comes in and sees that the kids can't take their rightful place. And sadly, 70% of our college kids leave town to look for jobs elsewhere. So education is critical. I would love to have our kids in a K through 8 school and then go on to high school. I think that would save money, certainly on the buses. That's a debacle in and of itself. And I would, parents become far more involved if it's a community. You build communities through your school. And then crime, of course, the mayor and I fight all the time on statistics, and I just take them from the Providence Police website. And then actually in the debate last night, he said, we don't fight about it. And that was a new avenue for him to go down. But we do fight about it because he's going on a 4-year, 5-year listing of statistics, and we're going on the year to date and the week.
So not the week. Not the smoothing.
No. So it's not good. And at the end of the day, if you're a victim of a crime, you're a victim of a crime and you're not happy.
Let's talk a little bit about that crime issue. You've advocated on the campaign that you want to increase that police force number being down roughly 100 officers. Talk about rectifying the current administration talking about having a surplus and balancing the need for increased public safety, because clearly there's a price tag associated with that as well.
Of course, there's a price tag associated with everything. So he is, let me tell you this, because of his posture and advertising and pandering on sanctuary cities, of which there is no such thing, there's no federal guidelines, there's no statute that says you're a sanctuary city, we are going to lose $650,000 in grants from the federal government. We lost $250,000 last year, and we're at risk of losing another $250,000 from the Justice Assistance Grant, and then another $150,000 from another federal entity. And that went to pay for half the overtime of the police because they're down. I would do, first day in, you have to do an audit of every city department. You would do an internal audit and you do an external audit. His $9 million surplus, smoke and mirrors to me. You know, you only have to make a budget work for an hour. And let me say this, there are probably a lot of people not being paid while the advertising's going out on this $9 million budget surplus.
So let's talk a little bit about that public safety. You got the endorsement from the Fraternal Order of Police here in Providence. When you sat down with them and you talked with them, what were their biggest concerns? Is it the number? Is it more than that?
So I am honored to get the endorsement of the rank and file. I'm also honored, I unanimously got it, of the retirees of the firefighters and the police. So that means something. That shows they are listening to what I have to say, and it also shows their dissatisfaction with the current administration. They talk about the police, the active police, are upset that the mayor micromanages the office. He tells them 1 week who to arrest, another week not to arrest. It depends which business is calling in, and they are demoralized. They're demoralized with his interference. They're demoralized that they can't arrest someone who may have a warrant, an active warrant, who's drinking liquor in an open bottle in the middle of downtown. So, and you can see what downtown looks like. You look out your window every day. I guess the mayor doesn't look out his window every day. They want to be part of the community. They want to prevent crime. They want to be strategic. They want to be community members too. So They're looking to me, my fresh ideas, and hopefully we'll make a go of it.
Now, this is always a difficult question when we ask challengers to elected officials. Is there anything you think this current administration has done well?
Okay. I think he loves his son. I think he's a good father from all the pictures I see of him with his child, with his baby. No, if I thought this was a good administration, I wouldn't be running. I'm running because I want to make this a good administration. I love this town. Everything good in my life has come out of this town. Even when things were at their worst, this town was great, except when we couldn't get off sidewalks, of course. So I think it's a wonderful place. We have such different populations. We need to blend and become a wonderful woven fabric. I love it, and I'm ready to handle any challenge that's thrown my way. My past experience has shown me that there's no task that is too large for me to handle. So,
let's talk a little bit. I know folks probably have been asking a lot on the campaign trail, Dee Dee. There's, you know, the past administration's not addressing fully the issue of the city's pension obligation.
Yeah.
Now, if you're in office for 4 years, you know, people probably are asking for specifics. How would you address that, you know, as we have a mayor who's saying there is a surplus, but again, that overall pension?
Right. So I do believe, you know, he talks about selling the water authority. You absolutely can't do that for a number of reasons. You're okay?
Excuse me.
That's okay. You can't do that for a number of reasons. One, you need legislative approval, and there's very little or no relationship between, that's okay. There's no relationship between the city and the legislature. I would also, he wanted an appraisal on the water authority. Very few people can do a proper, you okay?
Yeah.
You're short?
I'm good.
Can do a proper appraisal. He wanted it done at 6 weeks and at a great cost. And you can't do one for less than 6 months. Mm-hmm. So that's number one. I would like to monetize the water system, not sell it by any means.
Okay.
I would like to work with the legislature, and I would like Providence to be able to sell its water at fair market value and rate to the other cities who buy our water. And then, of course, use that money to put into the pension exclusively. And then move, with legislative approval, our retirees into the state system. I mean, to me, these are inventive ways. You don't just go for the low-hanging fruit of selling something. It's our asset. We need to keep it. And if someone buys it, which again, you need legislative approval, what's to say somebody bought it? They need to make a profit. Why should they be marking it up? Why can't we mark it up and sell it at retail again? So that's what I would do.
How quickly, again, if elected, would you move to address this? You talk about the steps potentially to take. Would it be during the first assembly session? Is this something that you would look
yes.
to achieve right away?
Yes, I would love to, yes. Because every day that goes by is, you know, is a day ticking with interest, and yes. You need to address this very quickly. I would love to establish a working relationship with our people in the State House and whoever our governor is. And remember, Providence is a city state. So goes Providence, so goes the state. And you land on your feet day one. And again, part of my humility is I always say, if I'm the smartest person in the room, I'm clearly in the wrong room. You bring people in who know more than you. Not everyone can know everything about everything. And I hope to have an administration that wants to be part of making Providence better.
So what can we expect for the next few days as the clock is on the field heading towards Tuesday?
All right, so we have one more debate on Friday with Channel 12, WPRI, right? WPRI. And I'm sure the gloves are already off with this mailer, which again, I wear as a badge of honor and a badge of courage that clearly he's very worried. And from essentially dismissing me to now seeing he has a worthy opponent, he goes around bragging that we were points apart. I guess that's just not true.